Rowena McGowan, intern at the Philip J. Curry Dinosaur Museum in Wembley, Alberta, Canada, and currently pretty much the luckiest person on the planet. I'm here today with Brett Crawford, who is a casting and modeling expert at Research Casting International, which is based in Trenton, Ontario. Research Casting International, or RCI, works on specimen preparation, molding, fabrication. They also do exhibit fabrication and exhibit installation. So, thank you for joining us today.
You're welcome.
So, can you tell us a bit about what you're doing for us at the Philip J. Curry Dinosaur Museum?
Of course. Well, we're doing a number of different projects, starting with the recreation of the Ceratopsian bone bed, and also an interactive dig pit for kids to get in and find their own little dinosaur bones and whatnot. We're also involved in many skeletons that we're currently installing with the plesiosaur, some pterosaurs. The gorgosaur is obviously the main attraction, and mosasaur and ichthyodonts. Yes.
Okay. And how do you become a casting and modeling expert like you are?
Well, I'm pretty lucky, I mean. But, well, there's many different avenues you can go within our company with a variety of artists, sculptors. Well, now we have 3D specialists. Well, and myself, I'm a metalworker, welder, and over the last 20 years I've become the head of the fabrication and the mounting side of our skeletons. So I basically take care of all the metal, internal armatures, the metalwork, posing of the animals, and the rough positioning of the casts for our finishing people to come along and tidy it all up and paint it up.
Okay. And what other kind of projects have you worked on?
Many big projects. Just a few. We've currently working with the Smithsonian Natural History Museum. We're totally rebuilding all their mammal, dinosaur, ancient sea life, all their skeletons. We're at our facility right now. We're rejuvenating all the fossil, and we're going to give them all new life, some new updated poses. We've also worked with rebuilt all the Berlin Natural History Museum in Germany, especially the world famous Brachiosaurus. We were involved in reposing, rebuilding the Brachiosaurus, numerous projects all over New York, American Museum of Natural History, like one of the main contractors. Of course, the Royal Ontario Museum in Toronto, we're heavily involved in one of the prime contractors with them as well, with recreating all their dinosaur hall and mammal halls and every other project that we've come along with.
Okay. And one of the models we have in the museum is a Ceratops, which is similar to a Triceratops. It's got the big horn and the frills. And you actually told me kind of an interesting story about how you created that skeleton. Do you want to read it for the listeners?
Yeah, of course. Well, basically, we it was just a pile of fragmented parts and some papers from Dr. Evans and Michael Ryan. And so we basically got some 3D scans of some other parts, and we basically 3D modeled the whole new the frill of it. And from the parts from Ottawa, parts from Alberta, and from Michael Ryan. So took all that information, jammed it into a 3D scan, and basically recreated and reprinted a whole new frill section, and basically this is probably the first Zero Ceratops skull probably on display, so you guys are pretty lucky to have that.
We're very lucky. All right, and my last question, what's your favorite dinosaur?
I like all dinosaurs, but to tell you the truth, my favorite dinosaur is not really a dinosaur, it's actually a marine mammal, Duradon, which is a sort of right in the middle of the evolution of modern day whales right now, so we started from land to sea, and sort of right there in the middle, that's a pretty cool skeleton.
All right, awesome. Well, thank you so much for talking with us. This is Rowena McGowan for the Philip J. Curry Dinosaur Museum, signing out.